Today we will read the third chapter of class 7, C.V. Raman, the Pride of India. Okay, we all know about the C.V. Raman. He was the first scientist from Asia who got Nobel Prize in 1928. For C.V. Raman effect. Okay, and today we will read about the C.V. Raman. Okay, and before that let us discuss the word stock of this chapter. The first is genius. Genius means talented, extraordinary. Okay, affection, affinity, love, delighted, happy, ravish, pleasant, hail, welcome everywhere. Throughout, end to end, from last to end, bottom, top to bottom. Essence, perfume, extract, scholar, learner or bookman. Commemorate, commemorate means remember, or immortalize, it means not mortalized. Flag, banner, curiosity, wonder. Okay, now let's start the actual chapter of this chapter, and we will go through the line by line of this chapter. Okay, and hope you will also follow and go through line by line, find out the difficult words, write down in your copy, find the meaning, and after that, having gone through a line by line reading, solve the problem of this chapter. Okay, see. Maple, class 7, chapter number 3. Let's start. C.V. Raman, the pride of India. Pride means honor. Honor of India. The genius who won the Nobel Prize for Physics with simple equipment, barely worth Rs. 300. It means he performed the scientific experiment just with the few equipments that didn't worth more than Rs. 300. Okay, and with the limited equipments he performed, searched and got the Nobel Prize. This was the peculiarity about C.V. Raman. Today we have lot of devices, equipments and everything, and still we are not in position, or we are doing something but not able to get the Nobel Prize. It is a matter of sorrow for all the Indians. In spite of everything we are not able, we have not done something remarkable that brought the Nobel Prize to India. But he had done. It was his greatness, only the greatness. Okay, see, he was the first Asian scientist to win the Nobel Prize. I have already told you, he was a man of boundless curiosity. It means there is no limitation of curiosity. And a lively sense of humor. It means the his sense of humor was very excellent, very good. His spirit of inquiry, his way of inquiry, his desire to of inquiry and devotion to science laid the foundation for scientific research in India. Laid means paved the way, gives the way, and a result laid the foundation of scientific research in India. And he won honor as a scientist and affection as a teacher and a man. He was a scientist as well as a teacher also. And he got the respect in both ways, as a scientist and as a teacher. Okay, see, read and enjoy the lesson. On the busy Bow Bazaar in Calcutta, now Kolkata. Okay, there was an old building. There was an old building. This is the posh area of Kolkata. It was the headquarter of Indian Association for Cultivation of Science. It was the building of Indian Association for Cultivation of Science. It means the medical research headquarter, research headquarter. In December, on a fine evening in 1927, there was much excitement in one of its laboratories. It means among the various rooms of the laboratories, in one room or in one department, there was much excitement. And what were the reason of that excitement? See, Chandrasekhar Venkata Raman. This is the full form CB. Chandrasekhar Venkata Raman. Okay. Was showing a visitor some of his instruments when a young man, K.S. Krishnan, rushed in and announced Professor Compton has won the Nobel Prize. He was doing the research, and at that time, K.S. Swaminathan, K.S. Krishnan, came and announced Professor Compton has won the Nobel Prize. Okay? Raman was equally delighted. Equally means as others delighted. In that way, he was also delighted. Excellent news. Very good. Well, he said, smiling at the visitor, and then he was lost in thought. Smiling at the visitor and lost in thought. It means he was thinking something. But look here. Krishnan, he said, turning to the young man, if this Compton effect is true of X-rays, it must be true of light too. Then C.B. Raman told K.S. Krishnan, if it is right for X-ray, then Compton effect is also right for the light. It means that was the reason of his delightment or excitement. Okay? A few years earlier, A.H. Compton had shown that nature of X-ray changes when passed through the matter. A.H. Compton shows the nature of X-ray changes when passed through the matter. The change was dependent on the kind of matter. This effect was called the Compton effect. It means there was a change of nature of X-rays when it passed through the different materials. Okay, and this was the Compton effect. Could light also change its nature when passed through transparent medium? This was the question. That was the question that Raman asked himself. For 5 years, he had been doing research in optics. Optics means science of sound, a science of light. The science of light. No sophisticated equipment, advanced equipment was available in the laboratory, but Raman was confident that he could find the answer with some modification in his equipments. And he was determined, in lack of advanced equipments, he could improve his research. Okay, 4 months later, on 16 March 1928, Raman announced his discovery of new radiation. Describing the behavior of beam of light passing through a liquid chemical. To an assembly of scientists at Bangalore, now called Bangalore. Before the scientists in Bangalore. This world hailed the discovery as the Raman effect. And this world welcomed the discovery as a Raman effect, or named it the Raman effect, because it was discovered by C.B. Raman. Okay. for scientific research in this country, it was a red letter day. Red letter day means important. His discovery caught the attention of the world with equipments worth hardly 200 and limited facilities. Raman was able to make a discovery which won him the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1930. With the limited facilities, having no advanced technology and equipments, he researched the Raman effect and won the Nobel Prize. And this was the lesson for those who told always that I have not this. And today, the students are also, in spite of making force on his or her discovery, they say, they make an excuse that I have not advanced equipments. This was the greatness of C.V. Raman. Raman was born on November 7, 1888, at Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu. His father was a physics teacher in college. He was a brilliant student right from the start. When Raman passed his matriculation, his parents were keen to send him abroad for higher study. But on medical ground, a British surgeon advised them against it, and Raman stayed in the country to do the MA course at Presidency College in Madras, now in Chennai. It means his family members, his father, mother, both wanted to send him abroad, it means foreign, for the higher study. But due to medical reason, he was not fit to go abroad. Okay, and so he started his study in MA course at Presidency College in Madras. Okay, science had already made an impression on him, and he began to write research papers for science journal. It means there is a huge love for science in his heart, and he started writing various journals and newspapers reports on his researches. Okay, when he was only 19, he became a member of Indian Association for Cultivation of Science. Meanwhile, respecting his parents' wishes, he took up an administrative job in the finance ministry in Kolkata. There may be some problem. That's why he joined the finance ministry to earn something. Okay. Respecting his parents' wishes, he took up an administrative job in the finance ministry in Kolkata. His interest in science, however, did not flag. It means how interest in science had not been broken. He used to spend his hours after office in the lab of association working throughout the night. He used to spend number of hours working in the laboratories every day. In his youth, Raman was mainly interested in acoustic. Acoustic means study of sound. The science of sound. He studied how strings, instruments like the violin and a sitar could produce harmonious music. He wants to know how the guitar, violin produce the melodious sound. It means good song. How? He was elected by the Royal Society of London in 1924, and the British government made him a Knight of the British Empire in 1929. It was a high honor for any great scientist. He was elected by the Royal Society of London in 1924, and the British government made him Knight. It means Knight means the highest post given by the British Royal Society. His advice to young scientists was to look at the world around them and not to confine themselves to their laboratories. He told to the young scientists, please don't think that I have no equipments, and you are thinking that this is the this research could be done, performed one with the help of some equipments, but it is not actually correct. It can be done without the help of equipments if you have knowledge and determinations, then you can do it. So don't make an excuse that I have lack of equipments, modern advanced facilities. Okay, see, themselves to the laboratory, the essence of science, he said, is the independent thinking and hard working, not equipments. He said the power of science is independent thinking and hard work. Think independently, not to some theories or other words or in your hard work. There must be hard work and good direction of thinking, you will get the success. Okay, see, C.V. Raman was the first Indian scholar who studied wholly in India and received the Nobel Prize. And he was the first Indian scholar who studied completely in India and won the Nobel Prize. It is a lesson for us, for the modern generation who used to go abroad, that there is nothing in our country and everything abroad. But this is not the fact. And this has been proved by C.V. Raman. That is called the brain drain. Okay. He was the first Asian and the first non-white to win such a great award in the science. He passed away in 1970 on November 21. But his memories are with us. February 28, the day on which he discovered the Raman effect, is celebrated as National Science Day to commemorate his remarkable achievement in science. It means on 28 February he discovered the Raman effect, and in 1928, and on the same day we celebrate National Science Day all across India as National Science Day to commemorate, to remember his research. Okay. And remarkable achievement. With this, we come to an end of this chapter, and we have learned that if we have determination and intention to do something, then the lack of equipment cannot stop us to do something extraordinary or research or such something. So, my dear students, we have learned from this chapter that we don't have to make an excuse, sir, I don't have, sir, there is a lack of this, there is a lack of this. No. If you have intentions and you are working, then you can do anything, and this has been proved by C.V. Raman. Okay, with this, we come to an end of this chapter, and let us write the theme of this chapter. The great discovery and invention can be Okay, my dear students, hope you have understood all the things. Please take care of yourself and don't forget to like, subscribe and share my channel and comment in the comment box. Thank you.